Oh, babe.
You forgot you had music for this?
I did. I completely forgot. I hope this doesn't get too awkward. It's just, I'm going to let it out. Yeah. I'm just, again.
Hopefully, you know what? This will be good for you because you can let it go.
Yeah. I can let it go.
Now, are these things that we all know about? Or are these
probably,
things?
Yeah. We might and not some of them, you're all kind of connected in a way, but I'm assigning it to each person. So I'm going to start with Ravi because she was the impetus of this.
Okay.
The time I was most upset with Ravi was almost a year ago to the day at last year's iHeartRadio Music Awards. We had a party that was being thrown by our general manager and market president. Kind of a big deal. Clients show up, bigwigs show up. We're supposed to be there as a show. I had no clue this party was happening. We had a very, very detailed itinerary that we had emailed to us, printed out. We followed it to the letter. Nowhere was this party on the itinerary. But apparently it was on our work show calendar, which is a completely separate thing. 9 times out of 10, somebody in this room will say, oh, I didn't know that was happening. It's on the calendar. And that's the excuse. It's on our work calendar. This party was on the work calendar, which had nothing to do with our trip to Vegas. So I'm sitting at the hotel, killing time until the festival starts later that night. A couple hours later, I get a text from Woody. How come you didn't go to that party? I said, what party? Kevin's party. I didn't know it was happening. So I saw Ravi later that night and I said, Ravi, you of all people, when you saw I wasn't there, why didn't you text me and say, Greg, where are you? The party started. I would have been late, but I would have been there. And she said, I don't know. I didn't even think of it. Now, had I gone to this party and saw Ravi, and you shrugged it off and you're like, I don't know. I didn't even think of it. If the roles were reversed, I totally would have realized, oh, I wonder if Ravi doesn't know about this. Maybe she's late. I would text her, Rave, what about the party? Oh my God, what party? And then, hey, Kevin's party, you got to be here. Oh, cool, thanks for the reminder. I'm on my way. But she totally ignored it.
I didn't even think about it.
So out of everything, that's when you've been the most upset with Ravi?
Yeah. Really?
Wow.
Yeah. And you all
even though Woody knew, Woody's the one that put it on the calendar. I saw it on the calendar. Men saw it on the calendar.
And that's the thing. This follows under that umbrella. You were all flipping about it. Like, yeah, Greg, whatever. It was on the calendar.
Didn't even cross our mind.
Like, it wasn't on our detailed to the day, to the hour list of things we were doing.
Yeah.
It was on a work. But Ravi was so flippant about it.
In my defense,
I was kind of
Kevin
drunk.
Invited me to the party personally. Cool. And then I just went. And there's so many people there. I didn't know.
That's right.
Who's next?
Yeah.
Next is you, Woody. Back in the OG days when we first started, this is probably 12 years ago, maybe longer, our original OG phone screener, Katie, worked for the show.
Right.
And you, for some reason, were convinced that she and I were having an affair, that we were sleeping
together.
Not
just me.
Well, okay,
everybody.
Yeah, everybody.
But everybody was convinced.
Now, in reality, Katie was the only person who knew I was gay. I'd come out to her, and so what we would do is go out to lunch or hang out, and we would talk about how I had just come out to her and talk about this guy I was seeing at the time. But Woody was still convinced, and apparently everybody was convinced, that we were having an affair.
Yeah.
We had a work trip to Lake Tahoe, where I found out later, you told everybody on the show, don't talk to Greg and Katie. They're being so sly and secretive.
No. You're missing that. You're missing the point. We had like some undercover investigations going on. So we didn't want
I was about to get to that.
Yeah. Well,
Menace and Spicy Nacho follow us around.
And Tony. And there was a number of people that were trying to get some type of evidence that you guys were
hooking up or messing around. Right. And
so
we would go into a hotel room together.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Let's keep it on the DL. But don't talk to Greg and Katie. So we could try to catch them. You know what I'm saying? Like,
we clued into it because we didn't want to make it
obvious.
Because we realized nobody was talking to us. And we knew it looked suspicious when we would go off to a hotel room together, inside of which we were just drinking wine and talking about me
being gay.
And then when we got back from the trip, you called me one random afternoon and said, I've made a decision. I want you off the show. And I've already called our program director and told him I want you off the show. And that was a big fight. I think I cried on the phone. And then we made up and everything was fine after that. But that's when I was most upset with you.
And then we got fired two weeks later.
And then we got fired.
Yeah, so what a waste.
Yeah.
Joke was on us.
Yeah, really.
Hey, why did he want you off the show? Because you're being shiesty.
He thought I was, that I wasn't coming clean.
Shiesty.
By having an affair with Katie.
I don't remember that.
Yeah.
I honestly don't remember that.
You called me at home and I've made a decision. I'm getting you off the show. I'm like, but what about, I've already called our boss. I want you off.
It was always weird because you guys were whisper buddies in the hall.
Yeah, and that's why.
I've never liked the clicky thing.
Yeah.
You know, because this whole thing is just like, especially like this environment's supposed to be where, you know, right. That's why everybody's involved in different things.
Collaborative things.
Keep that in mind when we get to Menace.
So if you're so if you're gonna be like an outsider, then you're not gonna be part of what we have going on. I just don't want that environment.
Right.
But I don't remember that, honestly. I don't remember that conversation.
Really?
Oh. That's crazy.
What, you mean Woody was wrong about something and ran it into the ground?
Jeez.
Well, Cameron, I've made a decision.
Yeah. He's already called our boss. Cameron's is so easy. I'm never upset with Cameron, but I have two words. America says.
You, Cameron.
Oh, yeah.
This, and it's not only the fact that America Says is my favorite game show, and rarely do I find a game show that I obsess about or a game show host I obsess about. Not only did you go on the show, get a call from the casting people, have all these excuses as to why you didn't even let me know. You let me know after you're on the show. Oh, well, they wanted people that met online. First of all, Mario and I did meet online. We didn't meet... Even if we had met on the moon or at the grocery store, I highly doubt that America Says has a detective agency where they go and spy on you like insurance fraud investigators. I wonder if they really did meet online and they have this weird FBI behind the scenes that America effing says.
No, you can say whatever
show.
You want.
You know, you can say whatever you want. And then after you went on the show without telling me, I said, how did it go? Oh, I had to sign an NDA. I can't tell you about it. Like, oh my God.
Yeah. I'm sorry. It's a legal agreement.
Okay. It's still so shady and terrible. And
that did seem weird.
Oh, man.
It was highly weird.
Yeah, it's very strange.
I'm sorry, Greg.
Like, I get some exclusive meet and greet with the Pittsburgh Steelers, and I don't tell Woody about it. I tell somebody who doesn't even like the Steelers.
Like Menace.
Right. And then go,
just sitting here.
I didn't know you would want to go to that, Woody. Oh, I had no idea. Wow. You've never mentioned the Steelers.
Yeah. Oh, blood.
Yeah, well,
baby, check it out. I went and met this guy named Lulu Smith Dooster.
Yeah, we hung out at his house.
Right. And partied with him.
He was cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He was a cool guy.
Oh, yeah. I did not know you wanted to go.
We had dinner.
All right, Greg, who's next?
Yeah. With Seabass, it's more of a general thing. When Woody trolls me, there's a look in his eye that I can tell. I think he might be trying to just get me angry or worked up. And then when all is said and done, he says, didn't you realize I was just trying to upset you? But with Seabass, the defining moment that I realized his trolling never turns off. It's 24/7. He's the Denny's of trolling. It never closes.
That's a great catchphrase, by the way. Slow
down. And that you never let up on it. And that was the hoverboard chair invention that I came up with.
Yeah.
This is like when I thought, oh, Seabass is one of those guys that he trolls everybody else, but not us internally. Oh, no, he does. Because
came up again.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah.
And when Metis had that hoverboard that he was totally into, I was too afraid to try it because I saw Woody fall on it.
Oh,
so
yeah.
I used it and sat on a chair and leaned forward. And then Seabass did it. Woody happened to see it happen. Oh, that's a funny idea. Oh, yeah, I just came up with that. And I'm like, you did not. And you would not let it go. And that's when I realized you're the Denny's of trolling. And that's the beginning of my disdain for your trolling.
I appreciate that, Greg. Let it be known that I never tried to get you fired, though.
Correct. Mm. As for Menace, and you were talking about clicks, Woody, I couldn't, even though Menace and I have probably butted heads more than anybody else in this room, I couldn't think of one specific time. So I'm thinking of an overarching theme to Menace, and that is when we all work together 5 days a week, like 12 hours a day, we do stuff out of work together, we travel together, we basically live together more than we live with our own families.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
But when there's an event, i.e. a concert, and we're all there as a group, Menace acts like he doesn't even know us. He acts like the rock star mentality, that kind of cliquish, I'm not even going to say hi to you kind of thing.
Too cool for school.
Too cool for school. Only at events. It's really strange.
Like, give me an example. Like, so he's not talking to you?
Yeah,
or
he won't say hi, kind of, you know, just turning his back.
Like, what do you say, like, rock star thing? Like, what do you mean?
Just,
like,
just an overlying too cool for school attitude. Not like
I think I know what you're talking about.
It's
like
hard to put my finger on
it. Meeting celebrities or
Rock like stars, it's kind of like well, I'm not really gonna pay attention to you guys. I'm just gonna kind of be cool over here.
See, Menace at most events is just on his phone.
True.
Like, there's sometimes like, you know.
Because he's working. He's posting. He's taking pics.
Yeah,
like,
I don't.
There's sometimes
I don't go on my way not to say hi. I swear to God on my life.
No, I believe you.
Yeah.
No, like, and that's what I'm saying. I had the hardest time coming up with Menace.
When we're meeting listeners, for example, and people are coming up and they're, oh my God, hi, how are you? Mm-hmm. I listen to the show every day. Like, I'll look and they're going, oh, hi, Menace. And Menace is like, I got to like hit Menace like, dude.
Say hi.
Like, say hello.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, and it's not because he's like looking right at them, ignoring them. He's on his phone.
Yeah.
Instead of like shaking the person's hand,
I'm not
or whatever.
Trying to big time anybody at all.
Yeah,
I swear
on everything.
But it's called feelings, and that's how it makes you
feel.